white, two.
You okay there?
Working it all out. Once and for all, Arthur.
What now?
We're back, and I'm sitting here, and I am contemplating the great journey of the sun and considering a famous chess move. Those Oilean actors of a mediocre justice, the Pinkertons, and their benefactor, the depressing millionaire Leviticus Cornwall, they want us, Arthur. They want us. And they are going to have us.
Maybe they ain't the problem.
Meaning?
I don't know. It's just, well, I can't help but feel we would have been better running off someplace else.
But the game ain't over, Arthur. I mean, I ain't played my final move, but
guess I'm more interested in surviving than winning a chess.
And maybe life ain't such a thing to cling on to so tightly.
No doubt. What's our move here?
You sound like Hosea. I miss him.
I asked you a question.
What do you think?
We can't stay here. That much is obvious. Where are we gonna run to? I mean, they chased us from the west. They chased us over the mountains. They ran us into the sea.
Arthur, do you have my back?
Always, Dutch. But there's more than your back to worry about. We need more money. We've been on the run for months now. And I seen you killing folk in cold blood like you always told me not to. And I'm sorry, but I can't help but think that if we
there is country in Roanoke Ridge past Butcher Creek, I believe we could hold.
Okay.
You and Charles, you take folks up that way.
Micah and I need to do some reconnaissance. I ain't got a final plan yet. Arthur, I ain't got it. I just need time. I need time and no traitors.
Charles, will you ride with me?
Always. Where are we headed?
Up past Butcher Creek.
Smurfy brute country.
That's why I'm asking you to ride with me.
I understand. What are we doing there?
We're looking for a place to hole up. Even the law won't follow us up there too willingly.
Yeah. I did some scouting up there while your boys were away.
And?
You'll see.
I know the way. Follow me.
We're going. We should go now.
Time to go, boy. We need to get this done fast. The Pinkertons will have reinforced in another day or two.
Yeah. The sooner we get out of here, the better. It's quite a ride up there. I saw some canoes near the bridge upriver, which would take us right up to Butcher Creek. Might be quicker. What do you think?
Yeah! Yeah, a boat's probably a good idea.
Okay, good.
It's good to see you again, Charles.
You too.
Thanks for what you did in Saint-Denis. Real brave drawing them off us like that. I was worried you and Abigail had both got yourselves killed.
I found a spot to lie low for a while, then managed to get a ride with a wagon of workers heading out to the fields. Abigail said she somehow managed to slip away when they grabbed Hosea.
You did good getting the others out of there. Keeping everyone together.
Watch it. Everybody was pretty shaken up when I got back to Shady Bell.
It was a tough few days. I couldn't have done it without Sadie.
So how did you find that spot back there? I assume the skulls on sticks weren't an addition to yours.
Old Strauss knew about it. The locals are terrified of the place, so we figured that might buy us some time. And it did. Until one of you brought the... Oh, come on. Until one of you brought the law with you. And where did you end up again? Cuba?
Well, not exactly. An island off of there, called Warma. Landed ourselves in a heap of trouble.
Really? A tropical island? Isn't that just what Dutch wanted?
I guess it didn't exactly live up to his ideals. Anyway, I ain't always sure Dutch knows what he wants anymore.
Perhaps not, but he's always managed to figure things out in the past.
I know. You're right. Just... It's been... Guess I just miss Hosea and his, wisdom, you know? Of course.
There's the bridge.
Whoa. There should be some canoes down to the right here.
Well, I see one anyway. That'll do.
Come on.
Where are you? Come on.
Butcher Creek is a few miles upriver. So I spent some time up this way while you were gone. I ran into Rain's Fall and Eagle Flies. The Indians? And I've been trying to help out a bit where I can at the reservation. Things are bad there.
That's not a surprise. They seem to be in a lot of trouble and heading into more.
Some men there spoke a lot about the Murphy gang that hides out in these caves. We're gonna need to be careful. They're animals. Everyone is terrified of them.
Great! Dutch didn't mention this.
Well, hiding up here is not a crazy idea. This is a spot nobody comes near, even the law. But just be ready. It won't be pretty.
So be it.
Butcher Creek up ahead.
Who are they?
The locals.
Well, they don't look too friendly.
Wait till you meet the Murph puppies. All right, let's walk it from here.
Hey, you know a place called Beaver Hollow?
All's I know is the devil's in these hills and he ain't gonna stop till he got us all.
Good evening.
you help us? We're trying to find a spot called Beaver Hollow.
We don't take kindly to outsiders around here.
Come on, they're not gonna help us. I'm pretty sure it's to the north, up the road here.
I can see why folks don't want to come around here. Ain't exactly a welcoming place.
Lots of stories of people going missing around these parts. Just recently, a stagecoach from Annisburg disappeared without a trace coming through here.
Guess that's good for us. Assuming these in- Inbred bastards are willing to part with their home, which I'm sure they won't be too pleased about.
No, but I believe they hide out all over Roanoke Ridge. These caves are just one of their spots.
Okay.
See that up ahead? Slow down, keep it quiet. Let's get closer to him.
We must be close now. Let's stop and have a look from the top of this hill there.
Dynamite be safer.
And hope they don't come out. Let's get this over with. Okay. Get in a bit closer and then throw it into the cave.
Come. Shit.
Get that poor girl out of the cage.
Please don't kill me.
Hey. It's okay. It's okay. Shh. You're safe.
Hannesburg, right?
Yes.
It's okay, miss.
The others, they killed them.
You're safe now. Just try to breathe.
They're animals.
I know. It's all right, miss.
Why would they?
Some folks is just evil. Ain't no point trying to explain it.
I haven't slept in days. Are you sure this is the right way to Annisburg?
I know. What's your name, miss? It's okay.
Meredith.
You're gonna be home soon, Meredith. And this'll all be over.
Thank you.
Where in Annisburg?
One of the mining cottages. If you get me to the main street, I can show you from there.
Okay. Just try to relax now. Yeah.
From there.
Yes.
Oh.
Here.
Oh. Thank God.
Which place is yours?
Up at the top of the hill. It's near the blacksmith.
Mona.
Ma! Ma!
Meredith? She's alive! Oh, she's alive!
She saw some pretty bad things, I'm afraid, ma'am. Murphy Brood got
her. Oh, my darling. How did you manage to?
I just ran into them and found her.
Oh, thank you. Here, let me give you this.
Okay. Thank you. That's mighty kind of you. Mrs. Dowd?
Oh, no. You leave me alone. You just leave me alone!
Thanks, buddy.
How you get on?
Okay. Found a girl. Took her home.
Oh.
You and Micah find anything?
Maybe. I think maybe. I found our old friend, Mr. Cornwall.
You did?
Yeah. He's buying a stake in the mine in Annisburg.
Relentlessly ambitious fella, isn't he?
Micah and I'll sniff about, see if he knows we're here, and exactly what his plans are.
So, Dodge!
Did you miss me?
I found her drunk in Saint Denis.
You're back. How jolly, Miss O'Shea.
It's funny, you suck of shit.
Back and drunk.
The master, the Lord
Molly,
God Almighty.
Calm down.
I won't be ignored. Dutch Vanderlyn, I aren't him. I ain't her. Or any of your stooges.
Calm yourself.
You don't owe me nothing.
Miss.
I don't owe you nothing. Nothing.
Okay.
I'll spit in your eye. I did. I told them.
I'm sorry?
I told them, and I tell them again. Now I've got God's ear.
You told who what?
Mr. Milton and Mr. Ross about the bank robbery, and I wanted them to kill you.
You did what?
I loved you, you goddamn bastard. Go on,
shoot
me.
Crazy. She ain't worth it. You told on me.
Oh, you're
you
not
betrayed
so now,
me.
Why?
You calm down. Arthur?
She's a fool.
Get her out of here. You know the rules.
You're not so big now. Are we, Your Majesty?
You...
Take her.
She knew the rules, Arthur. What the hell is wrong with you? Mr. Pearson, Mr. Williamson, get this body out of here and get it burnt.
Okay.
Now get back to work, all of you. Quit your lollygagging.
All right.
Get back to work.
Yeah.
Miss Crenshaw, a nasty woman. You think I wanted to shoot her?
You seem to like it. I saw that beady look in your eye.
Arthur.
You're drunk again, and you're a fucking murderer.
She broke the rules.
She did no such thing. She was in love. You sour-faced old crone. Goddamn you. Murderer! Murderer!
I did what I had to do, Mr. Morgan.
Perhaps.
Morning.
Are you doing well?
So you think... You think Dutch has lost his mind, Arthur?
I don't know anymore. I'm not sure I even care.
Well, Micah... Micah says you've been saying crazy things about him.
Micah. Keep an eye out for Micah, Bill. He says a whole lot. I'm worried about you.
No, go away, Arthur.
Okay. Just want to make sure you're all right. Well, try to keep your head straight.
Whatever you say.
Morning, Arthur.
How you doing?
Poor mom. I don't believe it.
You okay?
I guess. I didn't really know Molly so well.
Thanks for your help. Well, securing this lovely spot.
And morning, Mr. Morgan.
This world is unkind. But it won't break me. Not while I have you by my side. We get some money, and we can still...
Or.
They won't catch me. They won't catch me. And I promise, whosoever stands by my side, they won't catch you neither. They won't.
What happened to you?
You always have something to say these days, don't you?
I know he's your husband, but it's gonna...
I insist.
Insist all you like. Ain't happening. Arthur, tell her.
Tell her what?
She ain't coming with us to collect her husband.
Abigail, you ain't coming. That's the end of the matter.
See, there you heard him. Now let's go.
But
nothing. It'll be quicker and easier with just the two of us. Plus, John will be calmer without worrying about you. Ain't complicated.
Well, I ain't the crime sort, but I'm real grateful.
Yeah, we know you are. We'll bring him back to you.
Thank you! Thank you both!
All right, here goes nothing. The place is surrounded by marshland. Should hopefully give us a bit of cover to move in close enough to find a spot and look for John. This time of day, prisoners will probably be working the fields.
Then all we gotta do is take out all the guards and row our way out of there. Seems simple enough.
How many times, Marston?
Okay, bring us over. We good? Let's head for that watchtower.
Okay. I'll deal with him.
Let's head for that witch tower.
Okay.
Stay low. There's a guard up there.
I'll deal with him.
Okay. I'll walk him up. Thank you.
John.
Grab that rifle. You can use the scope.
Hey, you're in the way.
Hey, I think I see him. There's a group in front of that barn, just to our right.
Oh, yeah. I see two guards. Okay, take them out, and let's go get our boy.
Okay. Let's go over there and see.
Okay, come on. I think one of those guards was still moving. Arthur, let's keep moving.
Where is he? You see him?
No. You, mister. You know John Marsden?
He ain't working today. Put the gun down, lady.
No. You put the gun down. Now. Where's John Marsden?
He ain't in the work detail today.
Okay, well, I guess we'll go and get him together.
Try anything, I'll blow your damn head off. You clear on that?
Yes, very clear.
Oh, no, you don't.
Come on, partner. Why don't you apologize to the lady for pointing a gun at her?
Excuse me?
I said apologize.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
Ain't no harm done.
So, where do we go?
Towards the entrance, I guess.
And who's in charge of this fine establishment?
Jameson, sir.
Jameson who?
No, Mr. Jameson. Heston Jameson.
Is he a nice fella?
He's been quite an exacting boss at times.
I look forward to meeting him.
They're not gonna let you do this.
Well, that's gonna be up to you, my friend.
Come on, please.
So, you a popular employee, my friend?
Not especially.
Well, I guess we're about to find out.
Come on, march him straight up to the front gate.
You better hope someone in there actually gives a damn about this fool.
Guess we'll see. We're gonna have to shoot our way out of here regardless.
Don't shoot!
Okay, friend, be cool now. Just do as I say.
Drop the goddamn guns!
Jameson! Is Jameson in?
He's in South Denis.
They got Milliken. Got him and gonna kill him. Unless you bring me John Marsden. Right now. You got 1 minute. I'm counting. One, two, three.
Milliken, is it?
Yes, sir.
Will you count for me? I got talking to do.
Yes, sir. Of course, sir. From one or four?
Oh,
sir?
Very funny. No, we must be at 11 by now.
11, 12, 13.
Faster.
14, 15, 16,
17. Now, hurry up. 18, well, this 18, poor fool's gonna get his brain shot out. And over what? For nothing.
Milliken, don't stop counting. I can't hear you.
Hurry up and bring that asshole out here, you bastards. Come on.
Don't cry, buddy.
I don't want to die.
Yeah, I know. Hey, John.
Hello, you two.
Now, no funny business. Or Mr. Milliken here will stop crying once and for all.
Okay, today's your lucky day. Let's go!
Let's clear these and make a run for it!
Okay, today's your lucky day. Let's go!
Look out! How you think you're
Roxy. Today's your lucky day.
Let's go!
Yeah. Seems they need rescuing, Marston.
Nice to see you, Arthur.
There's some fellas coming here. Don't look too friendly. We best get out of here.
Come on, boys. Let's move. I'll row. You shoot.
Seriously?
Let me. You're a better shot. All
right, fine. You just relax and enjoy yourself, John. Leave the real work to them as can still handle it.
Thanks.
Keep the...
I think I liked you better when you was all trussed up like a prized chicken.
No doubt.
Well, hurry up. They're gonna be on our tail soon enough if you boys keep wasting time.
Oh, that's us told them.
Hey, Arthur. Thank you.
Don't mention it.
Let's go. We should get out of here quick before the law gets wind of this.
So what the hell happened in Saint Denis? Is Abigail all right?
She's fine. Jack is too. She managed to escape when they got Hosea.
Hosea? That still don't seem real somehow. All them years. Arthur. He was like... like family.
Yeah, we lost young Lenny too.
No. What a... goddamn mess. And did we... what about the money?
Lost somewhere at the bottom of the ocean.
What? How the hell did that happen?
We hit on a boat. It was the only way out of there. The boat went down in a storm, and we ended up stranded on an island somewhere near Cuba.
Cuba? Wait, you're gonna have to tell me all this again.
It's a long story, but things ain't been good, John.
You're telling me.
We're holed up now in the mountains to the north, near Roanoke Ridge, some caves there. The Pinkertons caught up with us again, and we had to move.
Yeah, seems Molly ratted us out, the bitch. So she's dead, too.
Jesus! Maybe you should have just left me to hang.
And... I should warn you, Dutch didn't want us breaking you out. Said it wasn't the right time, so... might not be the hero's welcome you're imagining.
So much for no man left behind. I can't stop thinking about this. In the bank, when they grabbed me, he saw it. Felt almost like he had a moment to do something and didn't.
Dutch ain't himself right now. Or... maybe he just ain't who we thought he was.
Guess we don't need to worry about who's his favorite no more.
Yes, not.
Brought him back to me.
We told you we would.
John! What are you doing here?
It's good to see you too, partner.
I meant I hadn't sent for you yet.
I went.
But I said that.
Yeah, I know what you said. I felt different.
Is that so?
Yes.
And when Spring and John brings the law down on all of us, what then, Arthur?
Well, I guess we'll have another fight on our hands.
Loyalty, Arthur, it ain't. I had a goddamn plan! John, you are my brother. You are my son. I was coming for you.
They was talking of hanging me, Dutch.
They was talking. They was talking. And now they may come and hang us all.
Arthur!
Oh, sorry. I was miles away, thinking of, I don't know.
Dutch said to tell you he and Mike have gone to Annisburg. Something about Mr. Cornwall.
Cornwall. Okay. Thanks, Mary Beth.
Thank you so much.
Well, he ain't done yet, Abigail. Dutch seems...
to have lost his mind? I know.
Just be careful.
I don't have to be careful. I have you as a friend.
Mr. Morgan.
Ah!
Jane?
Was you followed?
I said no!
Okay.
What is your problem?
What is your problem, partner? You don't look so good.
What is wrong with you?
Nothing wrong with me. I'm fit as a fiddle.
And I inside you ain't.
I'm just a realist, friend.
Micah reckons there's a rat.
Oh, does he? On what evidence?
He's only back a minute. Pinkerton show up.
We've been on the run since you two fools went crazy in Blackwater. We barely escaped with our lives in Saint Denis. Now we got a rat.
Well, Molly clearly talked, but who else?
Maybe we pushed things too hard. Maybe time for folks like us is past. We don't need a rat. We got sloppier than the town drunk, and they know who we are and where we are and what we're doing.
The way I see it, best thing we can do is let the week go. Move on, get our money, and start over.
That ain't happening.
Well, something's gotta happen, and fast. Otherwise, Cornwall, them Pinkertons, they've got us penned in here, and ain't none of them stopping.
Well, Cornwall's why we're here. Shall we, Dutch?
Yeah, it's time to go. Let's head to the river.
Leave Cornwall alone. He ain't. We need money. But revenge? Now?
Of course it's for money.
Come on, Arthur.
This better not be no stupid revenge mission, Dutch. It ain't worth it.
Don't be ridiculous.
Oh, Arthur, it's just a simple social call.
So, what are we gonna say to him that needs to be said?
He has been hunting us since Valentine. He is the reason that Hosea got killed. His sugar business is destroying the people of Guarma. This town, Arthur, it's his town. He bought it just to destroy these folks. His sugar, his oil, his law.
These are wrongs you can't right, Dutch. We're wanted men.
So why did you go for John against my wishes?
I didn't want him hanged.
Neither did I.
We're gonna cut a deal, Arthur.
What are you talking about?
We want out, and Cornwall wants us to stop robbing him, and we all know his money is what's keeping the Pinkertons on our tail. He's America, Arthur, and I want out, and he won't let us go.
This ain't making a lot of sense, Dutch.
It will, son. It will. A deal, some noise, and then we're gone. Cornwall's boat is due in soon. Let's get down here behind these crates. Arthur, I said get yourself hidden.
I want to thank you for your hospitality, Mr. Cornwall.
This was a business meeting, Mr. Milton. We are not friends. I have spent a considerable fortune with your agency and still nothing. This Vanderlyn robs me and laughs at me. I asked for the best. I paid for the best.
We are very close, Mr. Cornwall. I know you've heard this before.
Can't, sir. Send a telegram to Goldberg in New York. Tell him I won't borrow it more than 3.2%. Sorry, no, I have heard it before. And get that army man to pay his portage charge.
Yes, sir.
We are doing all we can within the confines of the law.
The law? I think we both know what you can do with your law. Find me Dutch Vanderlyn. Bring him here and leave the laws to them as need them. Good day, sir.
Come along, Mr. Ross. We have work to do.
Mr. Didsbury. Mr. Cornwall.
Now listen up, Didsbury. What's all this about strikes? I bought into this mine because of mismanagement, and and I intend to make it a success no matter what the cost.
It's the wages. Folk feel
Folk
that you...
feel? Business doesn't give two figs about feelings, sir, not two figs. And it's a nonsense that will bring a plague on both our houses, sir.
Perhaps there is a plague on your house already, Mr. Cornwall.
What do you want, sir?
I'm not quite sure just yet.
Your impudence will be your undoing, sir.
I'm undone already. Even my best friend here, he thinks I'm crazy. And like this poor fellow you are talking to, my feelings are hurt.
You robbed me, sir.
And you robbed him. Funny world.
You show a criminal's grasp of sophistry, sir. I did no such thing.
You kill. I kill. You rob. I rob. Only difference I can see is I choose whom I kill and rob, and you destroy everything in your path.
I've heard just about enough.
I'll tell you what. You give me this ship, $10,000, and safe passage out of here, I'll let you live.
I'll do no such thing!
You sure? Good. I prefer it this way.
You lost your man!
Noise, Arthur! Noise!
This wasn't a revenge mission.
It wasn't. We got what we
least we tried talking it out.
Boys, you lost your minds.
Oh, I've felt a lot of guilt in this life, Arthur. I've killed too often and poorly, but not this time, son. Come on!
All right, let's head for the hills, boys. They're trying to block us off. Go right!
Okay.
Interesting social call. Oh, don't play dumb and superior at the same time, Morgan. We all knew, sooner or later, Cornwall had to go.
Let me see them papers.
It's more attention we don't need. Feels like the whole world's closing in on us. Dutch, it won't be long before they find where we're hiding out now. Especially as we ain't exactly hiding out.
We just need a distraction. Buy us some time. It looks like Mr. Cornwall's company has signed a railroad contract with the army. And they're also moving dynamite down from, well, the Annisburg mines to San Denis to resell. And there's bonds at his oil factory. Maybe there's a way to get them off our back and get the money that we need. Micah, you look into this dynamite. Take Bill, I guess, Arthur. You go, too. We are gonna need a lot of it. And, Mike, we need to talk. Figure out some things.
Of course, boss.
Figure out what?
The plan. Getting out of here. Nothing's changed.
It hasn't, huh?
There's an old house west of Van Horn. Meet me there when you can, Black Lung.
Let's split up. We'll meet up back at camp.
Yeah. This is crazy.
Abigail.
I don't like this, Arthur.
Reverend?
You okay, Mr. Morgan?
I don't know, Reverend.
These are challenging times for all of us.
Yes, very challenging.
You don't seem yourself, somehow. I've always felt... I've left the morphine, sir.
Arthur, Reverend Swanson, would you excuse us a minute?
Of course.
New York. We are gonna go to New York. Now, they have been chasing us south and east and west. We're gonna get a boat, we're gonna get on a river, and we're gonna go north.
New York.
Then Tahiti, the Fiji Islands, or this place, New Guinea, dancing girls, freedom. But first, we have to make a whole lot of smoke, a whole lot of commotion. And then we disappear.
We need more commotion?
One score and one whole hell of a lot of noise.
We ain't so good at doing scores anymore, Dutch.
Are you feeling all right, Arthur?
Sure, fine.
Pardon me for interrupting. I brought a friend, Arthur.
Hello.
Hello.
Dutch, this is Eagle Flies. His father is a great chief. Charles and I,
pretended to be mercenaries. Did me a great favor.
Dutch Vanderlyn, how do you do?
Not well, sir.
Well, I am sorry to hear that.
How's your father?
Father has confused wisdom with weakness. His people, my people, we've suffered too much, been lied to too much. Now they've taken our horses.
Who?
The infantry division posted at Fort Wallace.
Why?
Colonel Favors is a liar and a murderer. His people won't stop until we're all dead. Without horses, we cannot hunt. Without hunting, we will starve. This is another act of war.
I see that.
You men have helped me before, and I have money.
Put your money away, son. What do you think, Charles?
You know I told your father I will not fight over some horses.
But I made no such promise. Come along.
Yeah. Arthur, we must go with them. To try to stop things from getting out of hand.
I guess. Come along.
We can get them more horses.
I know. I understand Eagle Flies is angry, but I don't see how this will help anything.
Especially not with Dutch whipping them up into a frenzy. We got enough folks coming after us without adding an army to the list.
You going to let these bastards walk all over you? No, you're not. This is all that's wrong with this world. Okay, young man, lead the way.
The horses are on a boat near Van Horn. I have a man waiting for us there with some canoes.
Surely this can be done without killing anyone.
Of course. What will be, will be. Anyway, son, tell me about this Colonel Favors.
He's a vile man. He and his regiment take the pleasure of persecuting us. All the young have been taken from our reservation, shipped off to reform schools. Many women, too. Nope. Are weak and sick, but they deliberately withhold medicine and supplies from us.
This ends today. You have my word on that.
Why are you getting involved in this, Dutch?
You know me. We shoot fellers as need shooting. We save fellers as need saving. Feed them as need feeding.
Not this again. It's been quite a while since we helped anyone but ourselves, and even you know that.
I told you, noise. We need noise, Arthur. Noise and faith.
I still don't know what that means.
Stop questioning and think. Just think for a second. The Pinkertons have had time to reinforce. The civilized world is closing on us. Who knows what else Molly told them? We need to move towards a conclusion, now.
Sure, but what's this got to do with any of that?
Some good, honest conflict between the army and the Indians might be just the distraction we need. Kill two birds with one stone. Cornwall
was funding the Pinkertons' assault on us. Why do you think I dealt with him? With Cornwall gone, the government is far more likely to divert them to other issues, especially if there's one more scandal. And we can slip away. Like I said, we just need that noise and one more score. You know, I went back for the chest I had hidden outside Shady Bell, and we're close, Arthur. That dynamite, the railroad contract with the army, it was all in those papers Micah found. I have a plan. You just have to trust me.
There's Peta.
These men, like I said, they'll help us.
I got the canoes. The boat is still moored in the channel.
Good. Just wait until nightfall. All right. We can set out.
I think the best plan is to paddle up there silently, board her. Then when we got control, we'll deal with that anchor and float away. We'll be ashore before anybody even knows what happened.
Try not to kill anyone, Arthur.
You mind the horses? I need smoke.
fast, Dutch.
I'm trying. We're headed to those rocks. Hold on.
What is wrong with you? Boys all right back there?
Yeah, I think so. But there's a huge hole in the boat. Horses are spooked, and we're taking on water.
Boys, get him out of here. Well, whatever else is wrong with you, you're quite the best pilot I've ever come across.
The horses are confused. We need to round them up. Forget these four, Arthur. Can you go after the others?
Okay.
Come on.
Over here. Come on. Come on. Come here. Come on.
Seems like Uncle Sam likes you fellas even less than he likes us.
So it goes. Your father doesn't want to fight again. Will one of you help me return the horses to my men?
Well, Arthur... Arthur needs to rest. I will. I like you, son. And after the horses, are we going to wait for the army to come and wreak its revenge?
I hope not.
Of course we ain't. Now let's go check out that fort of theirs.
Is this a good idea?
This is the only idea. And it is one that will suit both of our purposes.
Fighting the army ain't wise.
Stop worrying. Oh, and Sadie told me about Combe. Meet us at Doyle's Tavern in Saint Denis when you can. Shall we go, son?
Certainly.
We'll start some light reconnaissance out at Fort Wallace, and when Combe's dealt with, you come meet us there. We'll set up a good spot for you.
I don't know, Dutch.
Yeah, well, I do. This is exactly the distraction that we need.
Your father said that fighting was an impossible gamble. There's no winning for you in this.
Father need not know anything. He'd rather live in ignorance.
Come along, gentlemen.
Your father would rather you did not do anything so foolish. I said I would stop this from happening. Would you talk to him?
Speak with Rangeful.
Yes. Would you?
I just can't get any more involved in this business, Charles. It's not my fight. You head on back to camp, check on the others, Dutch's behavior.
I understand.
Thank you, Arthur.
There he is, old Black Lung Morgan.
Shut up.
Was you followed?
Excuse me?
Was you followed?
Do you know who you're talking to?
I ain't sure. I ain't sure about much no more. All I know is there's law whenever you're around.
Is that so? Because it seems to me that since you've been riding with us, there ain't been nothing but trouble. Stirring things up all the time, getting in Dutch's ear. Seems wherever you is, there's Pinkertons and vice versa. So you better watch your goddamn mouth, boy! Or...
Take it easy, cowboy. You're gonna do yourself a mischief, way your head.
Micah, shut it!
He started it! Dutch says we is to go on with plans to create a diversion. We gotta get some explosives to blow up the bridge. Keep the army out of here a few days.
I think it's a real bad idea.
I don't think Dutch cares too much what you think.
That's clear.
We gotta confuse him one last time. Then he and I will head to Blackwater, collect the money, and help everyone leave. He's got a boat lined up.
Blackwater's a fool's errand. Everyone knows it. Even a greedy moron like you.
It's Dutch's choice, Arthur. You're just a senior gun, same as the rest of us. Only you ain't well.
I'm fine!
Then you'll do Dutch's bidding. Which is robbing a stage that's coming from Annisburg full of explosives.
Rob a stage. All we seem to ever do is rob a stage, you and me.
Not me. You two. I got my own planning to do. You boys got this.
Shit. Guess we have. Come on, Arthur.
And cowpoke. You take it easy. You could do with a vacation, hmm?
All right, let's go. Says we should jump it as soon as it comes through Van Horn.
So you're taking orders from him now?
I'm taking orders from Dutch, same as always.
Paralam will be coming unhinged. You hear about Dutch killing Cornwall?
Hey, hold up a second. Pinkerton Patrol, over there. Okay, I think we're clear. Let's let's head on.
Anyway, you saved me.
Well, that needed to be done.
Right now? With the Pinkertons breathing down our necks?
See, I'm starting to think that you've gone soft, Morgan. Okay, let's hold up here. So, wagon will be coming from that way, down from Annisburg. It'll take the two of us to stop it completely, or it'll never get done. So, I was thinking, you go play dead, and I'll take care of them.
No, I'm the better shot, and you're the better actor. No, you play dead, and I'll cover you.
I got that. I got that. Oh, that's them coming now, I think. It'll be quite the show.
Get you out of... Thank you.
at your camp without blowing ourselves up. Nice shooting back there.
Nice drunk playing.
Comes naturally. I could use a drink after that.
Yeah, I know. Just never goes easy no more, does it?
All right, let's see if we can get this back to camp without blowing ourselves up. Nice shooting back there.
Nice drunk playing.
Comes naturally. I could use a drink after that.
Yeah, I know. Just never goes easy no more, does it?
Oh, shit! Deal with it!
Hey, I'm trying.
Quit! They get off one good shot and I'll blow his boat to kingdom come. I thought there was no law in there for me.
Does that really matter right now, Bill?
So we can rob some dynamite, blow up a bridge. Does this make any sense to you?
It's a distraction. So it ain't meant to make sense.
It should.
Look, there's Micah up ahead.
Great. Whoa!
So, you got it?
We got it. Yes, we got it.
What's wrong, Arthur?
Nothing at all, boss.
John, go drive this over to Bacchus Bridge. Get a hidden ear there.
He really does think he's in charge.
You go on ahead. I need to speak with Arthur. Good work, son.
What's going on?
Listen, I know we ain't always seen eye to eye, and you find me irritating and a threat, and I like to annoy you. But right now, I need better from you, Arthur.
Okay, Micah. Whatever you say.
I ain't the bad guy you think I am, Arthur. But I am a survivor. Stick with me and you'll live. Oh, the bridge is probably a two-man job. You should probably go help Marston.
Why don't you?
Like I said, Dutch and I got planning to do for the train. There's a big picture here, Arthur. Trust me.
Don't you worry about me.
There you are.
Here I am.
Come on, let's go.
Let's go where? And why are you so riled up?
Today is a great day, Arthur. Today is the day they are going to hang Colm O'Driscoll.
That's so.
Rather they hang him or I shoot him.
Oh, they are gonna hang him.
Yeah, and not before time.
That boy's been on the gallows more than most. I wouldn't count anything until his neck's broke.
Well, nor would I. Which is why, despite us being wanted men, we're gonna attend the event ourselves.
And follow him onto the scaffold?
Well, let's hope not. But if I could see that son of a bitch breathe his last, I think I'd die a happy man. We are gonna disguise ourselves.
In this?
In this.
Okay.
Come on.
Well, don't we just look the part?
We'll cut through the alley to get to the gallows. We keep our weapons holstered, our disguises on, and our wits about us.
Mrs. Adler, might I say, being a fancy woman of Saint Denis suits you.
I'd dress up like the Queen of Sheba if it meant seeing that son of a bitch swing.
Colm hung me up, nearly butchered me. That don't mean I'm comfortable in this woolen coat.
You made it out of that predicament, as I remember, Mr. Morgan. My husband weren't so lucky.
You lost your husband. I lost my darling Annabelle. That poor boy Kieran. We've all lost something because of Colm. You need to catch your breath, friend. I hope you got yourself in order. Come on, and that is why we will shepherd him to eternity.
Amen to that.
Now keep those fingers off those triggers, because we'll need cool heads and calm dispositions to see this done.
Practice what you preach, brother.
Whatever do you mean?
Are you gonna keep your cool? Really? When you seem to lose it all so often now.
This doubting and questioning of yours, I miss the old Arthur.
Don't we all?
You two quit it. We all got a job to do, and we're all in rough agreement about how we're doing it. As far as I can tell.
Exactly.
We'll get it done, all right.
All right, then. Come on. We got a hanging to witness.
Look here. Don't the public love an execution?
Hello, madam. So how is everything?
Hey. All right. Good. Now, you see that pair of assholes?
Sure.
They're Combs boys.
Yes, I think so.
What a surprise. I'm glad we're here. What are they pointing at?
I don't know. We gotta follow them to find out.
Yeah. Oh, here comes somebody. Stay here.
Don't do nothing.
Go brush that horse off. Officer?
Yes, sir.
The crowd came to see a show. We don't want to disappoint them.
I guess they did miss their chance to see John swing by his neck.
Hey. Hey! You know I wasn't going to let it come to that.
I guess I don't know what I know no more.
And I guess this isn't the time to question either my decisions or yours. Here and now, Colm O'Driscoll's going to get his due. He's turned down there. Let's go. Quiet.
What's it look like?
Bunch of cops.
How many?
Enough. So what do you think?
Paul's up on the roof. Once he starts shooting, we have to have our wits about us and move fast.
Yeah, I guess we faced worse than this before.
Sure. Let's get to it.
Yeah.
So, they got a guy up on the roof, overlooking the gallows. Find a way up there, onto one of these verandas, through a building maybe, and get him. And do it silently.
Well, obviously I'm gonna do it silently. I wanna see this bastard swing.
Ladder.
Where are you?
Hey, watch it.
Find a way up to the roof and stop him. I'll go back to Mrs. Adler.
That separates us from barbary. Yet justice itself can at times be barbaric. For sometimes a man is so savage, the only way to deal with him justly is by savagery. Colm O'Driscoll is one such man. He has murdered, tortured, robbed, stolen, raped, and abused for a decade across five states, seemingly with impunity. Today, justice catches up with him.
As well you may. I've been a bad man.
Silence!
These charges are...
This is not a court! where you shall be tried. This is a place where your sentence is to be carried out. And your sentence, Colmore Driscoll, is that you are to be hanged by the neck until you are dead. This is not a task we take lightly. It is not a task we enjoy. But it is a task we must carry out if our civilization is to prosper. Gentlemen, are we ready? Colmore Driscoll, may God, in his infinite wisdom, have mercy upon your soul. Whenever you are ready.
Now you know how it feels to watch somebody you love die. You ruined my life!
How you get on, Arthur?
Well, we saw the bastard hang okay, but no thing ain't gonna save us.
I guess that's one less thing to worry about.
I guess, compared to the entire government, in the end, Colmore Driscoll didn't seem like such a worry.
A letter came for you.
Oh, okay.
I know it's from that Mary.
Mary?
She ain't worth it, Arthur.
Who is?
My dear Arthur, I don't know if you received the letter I wrote to you from Saint-Denis a while back. It was foolish of me to ask for your help again, and I promise there will be no recurrence. I don't imagine you'll receive this letter either, but I nonetheless must send it. Arthur. Oh. Arthur, I was just starting to dream the silliest and softest of dreams when I read about your recent activities in the newspaper. I miss you, and I will always miss you, but I cannot live like that. And it seems you cannot live any other way. When I'm with you, the world makes sense, but when we're apart, I see clearly that your world is not a world from which one can escape. I am so sorry for everything long ago, and for starting up that business again. There's a good man within you, Arthur, but he is wrestling with a giant. And the giant wins time and again. I enclose a ring you gave me many years ago, when we were both young. Not because I don't like it, but because I care for it far too much, and it reminds me too much of you. I hope one day you'll find some people in love who can use this, for it kept me thinking of you all these years. And I hope by returning it to you, I can finally be free. Goodbye, Mary.
Why are you prowling around here?
Hey. Josiah?
I was
leaving again?
Yes, just leaving. I'll see you soon.
Perhaps.
What do you mean?
Well, if I was you, I'd disappear too. This is all pretty much over.
I'll be back.
No, you won't. Let's not pretend no more. Get out of here.
I'll miss you, Arthur. You've been a fine friend to me.
No, let's not get over sentimental. Well, the place is quiet. Get out of here. You go with my blessing.
Thank you, Arthur.
Found a friend looking for you.
Mr. Morgan.
Sir, how can I help you?
I am sorry to impose on you again, but I believe I've made progress brokering peace.
You have?
I believe so. Colonel Favors has agreed to a meeting to discuss and maybe resolve his alleged grievances and mine. Now, he has lied to me more times than I care to remember, but maybe this time he must want peace. Why could he possibly want to humiliate us further?
We got words for his kind, but they're colloquial.
Perhaps I could make one last request. My men are not allowed to carry arms.
You want us to keep the peace?
Yeah, it'll be a lot of dull talking and ceremony. But I feel with some non-tribe members present, their chances of lying or worse will be reduced.
Will you, Arthur?
It ain't my business, brother.
No, I know. But it is mine. Do it for me.
Charles, I got...
I've saved your life. Do it for me.
Sure. Come on. You owe this man. You should have him do your negotiation.
Let's go.
Thank you for doing this, both of you.
Ain't a problem. I wish we could have done more to control the situation. Dutch should not have gotten involved.
My son has a mind of his own. Too much so, in fact. I just hope Colonel Favors can be reasoned with. I'm not asking for very much, but when our people are sick and hungry, and we find our medicine and supplies are being deliberately withheld, how can we not view that as something personal? How can I convince Eagle Flies and the others that they shouldn't fight back?
Maybe that's part of the reason they're doing these things. Because they want you to fight. To be able to say, look, you see how these savages behave?
Perhaps. There's an army captain, Lyndon Monroe, who was seconded here from a regiment in the north, sent by Washington. A good man. He'll be at the meeting and he knows the true situation. I still have hope that we can come to an agreement.
up ahead.
Hello.
We chasha kela na kola we chiampi hiopo bunyapi ktelo. This way. Huh? Oh, excuse me. Watch out!
Colonel Favors, Captain Monroe, we come in peace.
Hello again. Who are these two?
They're friends of my people.
Hmm. Interesting looking fellows.
Yeah, they won't cause any trouble.
Well, I should hope not. Listen, Mr.
Chief.
Yes, Mr. I can't say that silly name. What is it?
In English, they call me Rainsfall.
Yes, yes, I'm sure they do. Listen, we're all Americans here, and we want an outcome. But quite frankly, I'm confused. Your men are little more than criminals, in my opinion. Keep breaking peace treaties we've made. Causing disturbances in everybody's lives. But I pride myself on being a gentleman. Really, I do. But there are limits. So, let me be very... Are you okay, man? Someone. Jackson, take him away. Where was I?
You're a gentleman with limits?
Are you being facetious, sir?
Come this way, buddy.
I said... Are you being facetious, Captain Monroe?
No, sir, I am not.
Chief Rains.
That's, Rains' fault.
Exactly. Chief Rains, the thing
it's quite
is...
quite a cough.
...federal government.
Sure.
Wait here. Situation. I'll fetch you some water.
I'll be fine. Thank you.
No, no. You know he's going to have Monroe court-martialed. Or attempt to. He's going to make a disgrace of him.
Monroe? It seems likable enough for a West Pointer. Why?
You know what Favors is like. Because he thinks it's right. Because he thinks Monroe is a patsy. Or a spy. He's convinced he has something to do with those vaccines getting stolen. He thinks Monroe is going to force him into making a concession with the Indians. So he removes Monroe.
Removes how?
Favors wants him tried for treason. And hanged.
Why does Favors care about the Indians?
Because he doesn't want to back down. His whole professional life. You know what they say about him. Hightail Favors. The man who missed a battle.
Poor Monroe. Kind of liked him.
I know. Well, still, he's kind of stuck up.
Your men violated the treaty. That treaty is null and void. I have been appointed to negotiate.
Feeling better?
Yeah. Come on. Let's go.
The lands you currently occupy belong to the United States government. Why is this so confusing, sir? Why?
Good day, Colonel Favors.
Well, that was remarkably unproductive. I'm afraid the federal government was quite clear, Colonel, that it wanted peace, and peace for all, and that the treaty had not been broken by anybody.
Oh, is that so, sir? And did it want impudence, sir, from a junior officer in public? Was that its plan too, sir? You insult me. You insult the regiment. Arrest this man.
Arrest me?
Gross insubordination. Disobeying an order. Treason.
Are you mad?
You had those vaccines stolen. You disrupted a negotiation.
Let him go.
This is all getting out of hand.
Captain Monroe, let's get out of here. If I were you, I'd keep my mouth shut, amigo. I don't want to kill this man, but shall.
Get off me.
Charles, Captain Monroe, mount up now. We're getting out of here.
We need to leave.
Just let him go, okay?
You son of a bitch!
What you're doing?
Just let him go!
Open fire!
Ah!
Ah! What do we do now?
You get out of here. Fast. Take you to the station.
I can't believe that just happened. I've been an army man my whole life.
I heard them talking. They was gonna have you hang for treason. You can't die for those fools.
And what about the chief?
You can't worry about that now.
I guess I won't be submitting my report.
I wouldn't think so. Captain Monroe.
I fear it may be Mr. Monroe from now on.
I'm sorry about your career. Here. Here's some money. You take it and get out of here and start a new life somewhere. I hear Tahiti's nice.
Thank you.
Just hop on a train to San Denis, jump on a boat, but avoid Guam.
Where?
Forget about it.
Meet you back at camp.
Reverend? Reverend. What are you doing here?
I'm leaving.
Running away?
Yeah, I suppose so. I'm running away. I tried to make Dutch see sense, but he's very strange recently.
And the women? Little Jack? You're leaving them?
I told them to run, too. I asked them to come with me, and they wouldn't. I've changed. I'm a changed man, Arthur. I won't die over some nonsense spouted by a fool.
I ain't changed. I'm still a bad man.
Maybe your path isn't changing, Arthur.
My path is coming to an end, Reverend.
I know, son. I know. And I know that you will face your destiny like a man, like a warrior. Because that's what you are.
That's all I am. A fighter. A killer. And a crazy man.
So be it. You lived your way. You'll die your way. But in the time that you have left, don't compromise. And you'll do everything that you have to do just fine.
We'll see.
I don't have to see. I know you. Fight and keep fighting.
Okay. Good luck out there.
Be true to yourself, Mr. Morgan, and leave the lies and the hypocrisy to fools like me.